That night before was probably the one of the weirdest nights of my life. Sitting there and everything starts turning quiet and you start thinking about my life is what happens if I die tomorrow. At that point I started telling my friends thank you for everything you've done in my life. It has been amazing and hopefully I see you the next day. At that point my life changed completely.
It never occurred to me that a complete stranger would give such a gift. Without that, then I would have ended up dying.
I don't think there's anything wonderfully special about myself. More just that it was an opportunity and I get to see life in someone else.
Salmon, Grant and Shelley were once unknown to each other, with nothing in common, but now they're all bonded by a rare and precious gesture.
I was nervous, but it was also exciting at the same time. It's something amazing to do and it was quite an experience and I don't regret doing it.
Salmon spent the morning having one of his kidneys removed. He's not ill, he just decided to donate it to save a stranger.
It's just giving somebody their life back and giving their family their life back. I think it's always worth it, you know, trying, giving somebody a gift of life again and changing their life as well. Kind of really changed my life.
Harvesting organs after death for transplant is standard in modern medicine, but living donor transplants are far less common and even rarer when the recipient and donor are total strangers. Although most of us only need one healthy kidney to function, fewer than 1 in 10,000 give their second kidney up because it comes with a high risk of complication.
Every surgical procedure has risks, and so we would explain to everybody who wants to be a live kidney donor that there is a chance of things going completely wrong during the anaesthetic and the operation. People can get blood clots in their legs and that they can go off into their lungs and or that there could be bleeding from the place where the kidney's been taken out of.
Anonymous or altruistic kidney donation occurs in very few countries. New Zealand, the USA, Canada, Australia, the Netherlands and Spain.
So for altruistic kidney donation is still a debated topic around the world, so there's some places you feel very uncomfortable with it. I think that in New Zealand we've probably done about 30 or 40 altruistic live kidney transplants. It would have been an absolute no-no. In the late 1990s we would have just said no way we're doing that. It's an unusual thing for someone want to give a kidney to someone who they've never met before. But it's something which we've all become a little bit more comfortable with.
New Zealand has one of the world's highest rates of altruistic donation, but one of the lowest rates of after-death organ donation. There's currently more than 600 people on the kidney list. Only 120 kidney transplants are carried out in New Zealand each year, and the list keeps getting longer. Some die waiting. But Salmon, Grant and Shelley are trying to change that.
The night I met Grant as a stranger was the night that forever changed my life.
It was a Friday night, and I'd finished dialysis at the hospital.
We were all just down at a bar in Hamilton.
The person who was being farewelled was fairly inebriated and lunged at me throughout the early part of the evening.
All I remember really was his top being pulled up and seeing a tube sticking out of his stomach.
So that kind of put a bit of a damper on the whole thing and people moved away. And there was one person who came up to me and asked me what the tubes were for. And I explained to her that I had renal disease, that my kidneys didn't work anymore, and without a transplant then I would die.
At that point I didn't know much about kidney failure, or I didn't even know about being a donor.
Surprisingly, responded by saying,
"Do you want my kidney?"
That random encounter saved Grant's life. He's been living better than ever before with Shelley's kidney for the past 18 months. The two of them have started Give a Kidney NZ, a volunteer-run organisation set up to inspire others like Salmon to donate altruistically.
Hi Salmon, how are you? Come through. It's good to see you again.
Yeah. It's a week since Salmon gave his kidney up. He made the tough decision to donate to a stranger after a close friend died from a kidney-related illness. Today, he's come to see Dr. Dittmer for his post-surgery checkup.
So it's looking pretty good. The old tummy's, the wound's healing up really well there. It's just a little bit swollen on the side, and the two portholes are all healing up, so that's good. All the strips just came off okay?
Yep.
Very good.
I don't know who the kidney went to, but it will be great to know the person. It will be good to find out how he's doing and how much it changed his life.
Salmon may not ever meet the recipient of his kidney. The rules of anonymous donation stipulate that donors are not told who their recipients are or vice versa, unless, as is the case with Shelley and Grant, donors or recipients seek one another out of their own accord.
Having a new kidney is like your first step, I guess, or your first smell of fresh air or the first trip to a foreign country. I have just graduated, I guess, from monthly follow-up to three-monthly follow-up. The kidney tests are showing that the kidney's certainly working extremely well.
I think particularly with the growing waiting list, it's made all of us and me think about who we should be accepting as donors and what sort of risks we're wanting to take or let people take.
The process from decision to donation takes up to 6 months, with a long list of medical and psychological tests a potential donor must go through before being approved.
We want to protect everybody and make sure that we only do the transplants which have got the least risk of anything going wrong, but still always have that slight worry in your mind that something might go wrong and that there could be a disaster and the next morning you'll be, you know, sitting there in a terrible, terrible situation.
Since I've had Shelley's kidney, there's a number of things that I can start doing again that I haven't been able to do for quite some time, for instance cycling. So getting back into that's been really important for me. They tell me that there's probably 20 years out of the kidney. So I can plan now and start to think about the things that I want to do. And I don't think I'm going to get old, quite frankly. I've got a much younger kidney, so I recalculated my age now to around about mid-40s as a result of Shelley's much younger organ.
Grant's new lease on life inspired Shelley to take the experience of giving her kidney altruistically one step further. She's now a social worker at her local hospital, assisting those suffering from renal disease.
It's been through working with people daily that I've really understood the impacts of what Grant faced around living with a chronic illness. And, you know, if you don't get a kidney, It does lead to death.
It's estimated there have been less than 300 altruistic kidney transplants globally. The UK and USA are following New Zealand's lead, with anonymous donor numbers slowly growing there.
There was a researcher in Brisbane who was saying, you know, what would happen if you wanted to be an altruistic live kidney donor, how would you do it? And so she typed in being a live altruistic kidney donor on her Australian search engine and it had come up with a big zero.
It's not a common practice, nor probably should it be. The risks are really the risk of death, which is probably quoted generally around 1 in 3,000 cases. The risks of all those things that can complicate any major surgeries.
Although deceased organ donor rates are on the rise in Australia, there's only been a handful of altruistic donations. There are currently over 1,000 people on our kidney transplant list. Samira is one of them.
I've been on dialysis for 8 years now, and it's very tiring. Needles, blood. Basically, it takes over your life. 5 hours a day, 3 times a week, is quite exhausting. Yeah.
I think because of the risks, because of the very unusual nature of what it involves, it's not a practice we should go out there promoting.
All they told me is that a kidney is doing really well, and that's amazing to know.
What I'd really like to say to Shelley is that, you know, saying that I love her in a gracious sense kind of doesn't feel enough. I certainly feel like she's a member of my family now, and I wouldn't have believed that, you know, true altruism survived in this day and age.
I'll never be the same again, and Grant will never be the same again. And I think I'm a better person for it, and hopefully I can inspire other people to do the same.